Hi guys, in this video I'm going to show you how to invert your text as you scroll over images and backgrounds in Elementor. It's extremely easy to do because I've done all the hard work for you, so don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button and let's get into the video. Okay guys, the first thing we're going to do is set up our page. And to do that, I'm simply going to drag in a heading widget and I'm going to add our text. I've already copied the text that I want to add into this box, so I'm going to right click and paste it in. The next thing I'm going to do is add a column underneath. And in this column, I'm going to drag in a spacer. Now, how you use this is totally up to you. I'm just trying to make sure you get the full impact of what you can do with this bit of code. You might not want this to be a column with a spacer. You might want it just to be another section on your page. So now I'm going to add the column and drop in a spacing widget. I'm also going to set its height on the left-hand side. Once that's done, I'm going to duplicate this column. And to do that, you right click in the left hand side of the column and click on duplicate. For the purpose of this video, I am going to make lots of duplicates. And the reason why I'm doing that is because I want to show you that the text color will change with each column. Each column's going to have its own background color. And as I scroll down the page, the text will change color over each one. Now I am going to be showing you how to make the text sticky to top. You don't have to do this, you could just have a multicolored background and instead of having spaces you could have the text fixed across that background and just adjust the padding of the text. Now all that's done, I'm going to add a second section with an image. Now I should have picked a section with two columns, but I actually only picked the one. So like before, I'm going to click in the top left hand side of the column and click on duplicate. And it's in this first column I'm going to add an image widget. And this image is going to be black and white. So I'm going to click the add image button and select the piano keys and click on insert. Like I said before, this could be the hero image of your page, or you could have this set as a background. Before I show you how to make the section sticky, I'm going to add a spacing widget. And I do that by clicking on the menu widget icon in the top left hand side and selecting the spacer and dragging it in above our text. Now we're going to make this section sticky, and we do that by clicking on the edit section button, clicking on the advanced tab, then clicking on motion effects, and next to where it says sticky, click on the drop down menu and select top. As you can see, if we scroll down the page, our heading sticks. What we're now going to do is add our CSS code, and we do that by clicking on the edit section button, going into the advanced tab and scrolling to the bottom to custom CSS. Now what you're going to need to do is head over to my website where you'll find this exact page and copy this section of code. Once you have copied it, paste it into your custom CSS box on the left hand side. Once you have pasted it in, go back over to my website and scroll to the bottom of the page where you'll see the CSS class's name. Now what you're going to have to do is go back over to your website, go into the advanced tab of the section and go into layout. And it's this here you'll need to paste into your CSS classes of your section. Once you have pasted it in, the color of your text will change, indicating the code is working. Now you may not spot the change, but it has gone from pure white to an off cream. So just to show you again, I'm going to delete one of the letters to show you that it has changed. Depending on the color of the background, it depends on how much the color of the text changes. Now all that's left to do is preview the page. And we do that by clicking on the preview button next to the publish button in the bottom left hand side. Once the preview page has loaded, all that's left to do is scroll down our page and you'll notice the color will change of our text over each section. And this also works over the top of our images. Remember, you don't have to make the section sticky. This is just so you can see it in full effect. This could quite easily be text over a static background or a static hero image. However you decide to use it, it's entirely up to you. But you will need Elementor Pro to be able to use the CSS function in Elementor. If you haven't got Elementor Pro, there is a link in the top of the description below. It is an affiliate link. It doesn't cost you any more to use, but it does give me a very small percentage of Elementor's profits if you choose to sign up. Hopefully you have found this video useful. If you have any questions, please feel free to drop them in the comments box below. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.